Enough querying data is running your queries directly against the data source. In order to do this, you need to create live data models. With live, you prepare your data as needed, connect to the data source, and run queries against the data source itself. You can refresh your dashboards manually or set them to refresh automatically every few seconds with the most up-to-date data. This means that you can see data in near real time in Sisense without having to build an ElasticCube model. This is different from ElasticCube data models, where you query the data that was imported into Sisense. With live, none of your data is actually loaded into Sisense. The queries are run directly against the source. You would probably want to create live data models when your data changes often, every day or several times within a day. This way your data will be refreshed in your dashboards immediately without having to run a build. To connect, click Live. Select the data source and connect to it. Now select the tables you want to bring into the data model. Then create the desired relationships across these tables. To get a better understanding of your tables, you can open up the different tables and preview the underlying data. But none of this data again is being loaded into Sisense. The preview is a live query into your database. If I go into the menu of these tables, you will see that there are several options for working with data and applying different semantics. However, live data models do not include the ability to transform data. Everything you see so far is consistent with what you see in an ElasticCube data model. This small indication here indicates that you're working with a different type of data model, a live model. All I need to do to make this available to my dashboard is click Publish. Publishing the live model adds it to my list of data sources from which I can select when creating dashboards. Publishing is different from building, the term we use for ElasticCube data models, in the sense that publishing does not bring the data into Sisense, it just makes it available to the dashboard. Using the live data models, you can create dashboards whose data will be updated at near real time. You can even create combined dashboards where some widgets are based on live data models and others are based on the ElasticCube model. To illustrate this, I've prepared a dashboard that is working with two widgets. One of these widgets is pointing to my live SQL example. The other widget is working on top of the sample e-commerce ElasticCube model. So I've built a widget based on live here, using a field from the product cost history table, and another field from my product table. This widget is showing a join being done on live, and that's something that I'd want to be running live because it shows changes to my list price. And you can imagine that if my prices change frequently, every day or several times a day, then I'd want my dashboard to reflect this. And on my ElasticCube widget down below, I have an analysis of the average quantity of my products across a few countries, which shows the kind of workload that I'd want to run in an ElasticCube, which is historical, long-running, aggregated statistics off of a value of a data set. So this is something where I'd want to leverage the performance benefits of pulling the data into an ElasticCube. So as you can see, live models are a great way to always have the latest and freshest data in your dashboards. For more information about live data models, see our online documentation.